I have experience in incubators, and I'm an entrepreneur myself. I'm an architect from the Netherlands in Greece. We started an incubator in Athens at the Netherlands embassy there, and that was something totally out of the context because embassies do not do incubation programs, but we did, and we started, and that was pretty successful, and thanks to the ambassador there. And then I was asked to investigate what are the opportunities for other embassies around the world. So I was in Ghana, where I met Tony, to see what's going on, where, by whom, when it comes to startups, and to see what the embassy could do for this group of people. Because I strongly believe that once the young entrepreneurs of a country do well, the economy does well, and when the economy does well, the trade between the two countries does well. So after that, I went to South Africa. On my way, I stopped in Uganda, and I'm in Zimbabwe organizing creative sessions with different industries and talking to policymakers, such as the Honorable Minister of SME. We had a dinner with her yesterday. Tomorrow we have a tweet table with the Minister of ICT. Just to address that entrepreneurship, yes, it is a solution for difficult and challenging economic times, but in order to foster entrepreneurship, you need to pay attention to education and to the basic business skills that entrepreneurs need. So the Netherlands Embassy is investigating that exactly. What is it that the young Zimbabwean entrepreneur needs? And there are no funds available. I need to say that in advance, but funds are not the problem. Never, ever have they been a problem.
My name is Tony Senaya, a young entrepreneur from Ghana, and I am into footwear manufacturing, and I work with a company called Horseman Shoes. That is the brand, actually, Horseman Shoes. We manufacture shoes locally, and our vision is to be the biggest leather product manufacturer in Africa in terms of employment and brand preference. Literally, the features of horses, they are strong, they have stamina, they are determined, and they finish their race. That is what we want to see in the young people that we are selling the shoes to. Everybody or every young person have aspirations where they want to get to. Before you get to where you aspire to be, you have to get stamina. You have to have a lot of determination, and it is a race that you must complete. You therefore need a horseman shoes. And the other inspiration is when we ask people who their role models are, who inspires them, they will actually tell you people who have achieved. And those people are horsemen. How do you be like them? You need a horseman shoes to keep yourself on the track, have a lot of stamina, have a lot of determination. So horseman shoes. I had a local footwear manufacturer do for me a pair of shoes. I took it to work. I was then doing what we call national service back home. It's a mandatory service you do for the nation when you leave school. My colleagues were amazed that I could afford that kind of shoe. But I told them no, I didn't. It was not an imported shoe. It was a locally made shoe. Then they started placing orders for me. Then I realized that even though Made in Ghana had a very poor image in our sight, still it didn't matter to the Ghanaian where the shoes were coming from, provided they were of top quality. So I found opportunity in there. On the other hand, I knew young people who could do very well, like me, who could make very good shoes. And on the other hand too, I also knew young people who were looking for shoes to buy. So I had to connect them. So, I mean, that was when I jumped into it, created my own brand, set up my small workshop, and brought in these guys, one, to create employment for them, and secondly, move Ghanaians away from patronizing secondhand products and, of course, cheap and inferior products from Asia. So that was the inspiration that sent me into Horseman Shoes. Creating employment for the young Ghanaian people and also creating something for ourselves. I thought that as a people, we deserve something better. My message has always been simple. Look, everybody has ideas, but the most important thing is the beginning. Never be afraid to fail. Once they get over that fear of failure, I believe everything else is surmountable. Because when you talk about challenges in the system, yes, of course, we are all facing them, but you see, people will always find a way, so why not you know? So always overcome the self-doubt and the fear of failure. And again, do not let money be your motivator. Your idea should solve a problem. And it always starts with the smallest of ideas, not the biggest of ideas.